So we've seen some major changes in the landscape of the major cloud providers. Whereas a few years ago, they were all competing on infrastructure as a service. Now there seems to be a movement towards intelligence as a service. So all the major cloud providers now have near parity offerings in various sort of cognitive intelligence areas. There is still room for niche players to be competitive in this space, but we are seeing a lot of acquisitions, such as Facebook acquiring wit.ai and Google acquiring api.ai. But now the new competitive advantage is moving really into machine learning, machine intelligence space.
One key trend is the increased compute power. We are beating the Moore's law with FPGA-based deep learning accelerators or custom chips and ASICs specifically designed for machine learning. We've collected massive data sets, voice, image, and video. We have capability to cross-reference and stitch together these data sets and get better results.
Some of the algorithms have been around for quite a while, but there is incremental improvement happening there. And on top of those three major trends, we're seeing two other pieces happening at the same time, which are really important. One is the growth of voice and chat as a new interaction pattern, and the emergence of augmented reality and virtual reality, which is driving companies to have intelligence on the real world.
Los riesgos son varios. En el fondo, hay que ver desde los más obvios. Por ejemplo, como que todos estos datos que son los registros de nuestra voz, imágenes y fotografías, van a quedar almacenados permanentemente en los repositorios a los que los usuarios no tenemos acceso y no podremos borrar ni podremos poner ninguna restricción en la forma que son utilizados. Estos registros siguen alimentando repositorios que monopolizan los datos que existen en el internet por las grandes compañías tradicionales y que van a hacer que ahora sus modelos se vuelvan también monopolios porque van a ser los únicos que tengan esa cantidad de datos para ser alimentados. Dado que los modelos para aumentar su nivel de precisión necesitan de conjuntos de datos que mientras más grandes y más variados son, producen mejores modelos.
So we think there's a few things that most organizations should be doing. One is beginning to explore the new evolving interaction paradigms. Organizations have new ways and new places and times to interact with their customers. So I think this is really important to explore how to bust out from just where you're constrained to a mobile phone or a computer. We also think that there are new categories of data that are now addressable by compute and analytics. So voice, image, and video are very particular ones that are becoming addressable by these new intelligence as a service offerings. We think about this as having better situational awareness.
If you want to get started with AI and machine learning, start with small incremental slices. Pick a narrow AI problem and a value proposition that will give you big win. Get basic data engineering in place so you can have good quality data flowing rapidly to an accessible data store or data lake. Focus on sourcing, cleansing, labeling, anonymizing, and most importantly, making the data easily accessible to people in your organization.
These new intelligence as a service offerings are changing what counts as commodity. So things that used to be really differentiating, the ability to do image recognition or natural language understanding or deep learning, is becoming commodified. What that means now is we have a new area on which to compete. We've got to look at where do we differentiate ourselves, and that's really understanding what you as an organization, what intelligence, what knowledge you have that can help your customers if you can surface that intelligence.